Right then, so we're on a little Cessna at Cardiff Airport. So fuel's on. Let's turn our avionics on. Lights and strobe lights all hidden behind the yoke there. So we're just going to do a bit of sightseeing with the local area. Right then, let's put our flaps to stage one. And let's... get this seat comfortable. And let's get taxiing out. I don't think we need you to turn off, do you? Okay. So let's go and have a look at our little pleasure trip today, then, shall we? Head up towards Cardiff. Trim now just to get that nose sort of levelish. There's Cardiff Airport. dock area. That is actually Cardiff. That could be the Cardiff dock area if they want as well. I actually think that's more likely to be Cardiff. But I should have got my VFR map out, to be fair. The bridges seem to be missing. Scenery details on why the bridges seem to be missing. just basically trying to track the M4, really. CDC. Oh, the distribution centres. Splits at the services, which is just coming up. And the bridges aren't being shown. That'll be something I'll have to look at in the XCME software. Again, the distribution centres. A fair few of them down there on that coat. So the bridge is actually starting to come into view now. There's a range on the on what we can see visually. The bridges. We'll have to check that the bridge range is changed. So there's services. Not many parked up today. The old M4 now, up towards Chepstow. Yeah, there's the bridge. You can actually see the new bridge, although not highly detailed. Again, I'll have to look into the scenery there. So there's the motorway split. That's the new M4 and the old M4. We're going to follow the old M4 route. And yeah, I can start seeing the old bridge as well. I'll have to look at updating the scenery on those bridges and see if we can get a better representation. Because they're not really that well represented in the standard scenery. And this is just to put into real words, this standard basic scenery. This is nothing special. This is nothing added on. No added on freeware. This is just the box standard, out of the box standard scenery. slightly. Still following the old M4. In front, going over the old part of the old bridge with the old CVCs down here. We're going to be following this junction for a short while now. We're going to turn off slightly. This is junction one. I have a friend who lives down here. Let's bank over slightly as we circled. And hopefully he will be able to pick out where he lives. Doing an orbit of this area just so my friend can pick out where he lives. Do a tight turn. Brown building is supposed to be Tesco Superstore. to carry on with our little trip. Just grabbing a mouthful of tea, please, excuse me. One of the things you have to do when flying visual flight rules is follow routes that you know you can pick out. So, for example, following the M4 per loop. You picked up the M4 again. One of the standard rules is when you're following motorways with VFR like this, you actually fly to the right so you can see the motorway just below us. The reason why you fly to the right is if I'm flying to the right as I follow it, then anybody coming the other way will be flying right as they follow that, and therefore totally, I've no idea what this route is. I want to head back out towards another area of a friend of mine. Beautiful weather for flying. Picking up the M4 again. The motorway services junction 1. M4 there. Considering the Asobo software, it reads satellite imagery and then tries to populate buildings that sort of that it represents. So it does such an amazing job. Again, all the terrain is highly textured and highly mapped. The buildings won't always look exactly as you want them, but houses, representation, street views, unbelievable. You would be able to pick out your house on a street, for example. Junction. This would be the Celtic Manor Hotel and Golf Range. You can see we've got the golf. That's the golf. It's actually a very big golf course. Looking at that from the air. There's the junction. That's the Celtic Manor Hotel just directly below us. You see, not fully represented, which is a shame, but we can pick out if it is, and of course the golf course directly below. Total bridge missing there, look, it's under the water. One or two little things to iron out. Do an orbit so I can get my bearings. out of the valley. Altitude, so we're just to give us that little bit of coverage extra. We're in the middle of the valley at the moment. That way, so we'll just climb up and over and then do a circuit view. Yes, I'm just going to do a new magnet. So we're turning off now, following the dual carriageway over the river, heading up towards Blackwood. need just a little bit of altitude so I can actually follow the boat. I think that's possibly the first or second turn. That's Blackwood directly in front. So, my friends, that's the end of this sightseeing tour. Obviously, I'm going to be going all the way back now to land. But I'll end the video here for some of you guys. I know it's probably been way too long already. I hope you've been able to pick up some sights that you know well. If I've missed your place, I do apologise. But we'll see what we can do next time. So, we hope you've enjoyed this little sightseeing trip. And we'll see you again soon. Bye-bye now.